Okay, I guess this will be a little bit different presentation of what we saw today, just because I don't like this nice commercial presentations and so on. No, not my thing at all. So I want to try some new stuff. Let's see how that goes. I'll need your participation a little bit. I'll get there. What else for beginning? I'm not going to tell you anything new. I expect that you know what is DevOps. Everyone is talking about it, I don't know, for at least a year already. Actually for last 5 years. So enough of that. One target definitely for today was to don't talk what is DevOps. But we will touch that as well, just for those who kind of don't know it. By the way, is there anyone who knows what is DevOps? Okay, that's good. Okay, maybe that's my ego or something like that. I want to start with myself. How I started, yeah, pictures are quite bad. That's something like, I don't know, 18 years old. Yeah, ordinary geek, always single. Yeah, that's how it is for IT. It started something like at fifth grade. I had this old Intel 486 computer. I know its parts. I know that there's Norton Commander, and I was playing with scripts back then. I didn't know what I'm doing. My father wasn't happy about what I was doing. But it was how it was, and basically that was first experience kind of automation, of scripting. I was just too lazy to open, let's say, Norton Commander every time, so I decided I can automate it. And I was something like, I don't know, 12 years old, so yeah. And basically that's how it started. So next thing, yeah, I went to Nexum Insurance Technologies, and that was interesting time, very interesting time. The story I tell always, that at very first days I got brought in by managers into a very small room, all of them sitting around me, having a paper and drawing the CC, what actually means cruise control. And I had no idea what that is, and basically they said, please implement this. And I was really like, what? But that's how I started, that's how it started. They had some scripts, they wanted some system which will trigger them instead of Microsoft Windows Task Manager doing that for them, and it usually failed. Okay, what else about it? So basically those were most important technologies, what I learned there, what I kinda implemented there. If we talk about TFS, who knows TFS? Okay, cool. So I can't say anything bad about Microsoft, but TFS 2005 was a it had kind of stuff for build automation, and you needed to go into a registry and do something. It was crazy. But over time it improved. Now it's a great platform, definitely, if you're on .NET, yeah, use TFS. But yeah, then the next thing, who knows CityCo? Yeah, right. Great company, definitely. Well, that's where I needed to change everything. I was on .NET, and those guys asked for Java. What is Java? Okay, 2 weeks of learning, done. What is Ant Hill? 2 weeks of learning, done. And we rebuilt all kind of their continuous integration process from, again, cruise control to Ant Hill. Great success, downtime for 2 weeks of continuous integration. Later on, when the whole company was migrated to it. Yeah, that's how it happens. Wasn't my fault, as usual. It's no one's fault. What's interesting about it, I don't know. It's just, again, great place where to learn different technologies. Great time there. Spent something like 5 years. Cool. Then, I tried to work kind of freelancing in News International in London, and those guys, they needed Anthill, but they were making kind of mobile apps, and again, I had no idea how to do that. So there I had that chance to learn everything about mobile. That was my first experience with S3, that was first experience with NoSQL. Yeah, again, great times, cool. And finally, Accenture, of course. Yeah, I forgot one thing. One trick I wanted to try is that kind of audition opens when you start taking off your clothes. Does that work? What do you think? Yeah. It is like that. Okay, so I'll try that, right? Oh, this is not going to work. Can you help me? Okay. Yeah. I was hiding. Now you're imagining what will happen, right? But no. It's all good. It's Accenture, right? We make jokes and we have a good time there. So about Accenture, I can't say that we were doing true DevOps at the beginning, but that's the first kind of point where we started to do later on actually DevOps. Previously in all the companies it was just separate unit doing automation and so on. I'll get there in a second basically, but yeah, that's our team now. Come to Accenture if you're interested in DevOps, right? Great team, lot of girls. Usually IT guys are kind of interested in that when they are searching for a new job. So yeah, recommend. What else? So again, new technologies, Nexus, WebLogic, a lot of stuff, Docker, everyone is talking about it. And Accenture, we started using it basically when it appeared. Oscar is in a room, I guess I saw him somewhere. He's definitely our best guy. And that's how it is for now. I'm there. I guess for a long time. Cool. Technologies. I guess you see that there's something odd with my head, right? So basically, I'm in technology, why I'm showing this is that you can't do DevOps with tools. That's basically the very first message, and that's basically where a lot of companies, a lot of projects, they just fail there. They get those new DevOps tools and let's do this. Unfortunately or fortunately, DevOps is about culture, about socializing and so on. I'll get there. So, one more very, very important thing, I think, is being a yes man. Have you seen that movie? Yeah, I don't know. I love it. I was watching it and I was really like, yes, this is the way of life. Go do something. Don't stop sitting around and saying this stuff is manual, this stuff doesn't work. Automate it, test it, make it self-testable. At some point, you'll be doing DevOps, I hope. Okay. I guess I'm a bit slow. That's not a bad thing. What I want to try now is kind of a little, let's call it psychodrama. I need a volunteer, true developer. It doesn't hurt, really. It will be fine. Okay, cool. We have one. Great. And of course, I need kind of true system administrator working somewhere, I don't know, in financials, in banking, something like that. Anyone? Sorry? Okay. Please, I'll give you t-shirts, right? So, please guys, one from operations, all I need. Anyone? Yes, cool. By the way, do you know what is Start IT?
Yeah.
Do you have children?
No.
Great. Okay, that's a gift for you. That's a real ops gift. That's a gift for you, but from Accenture, so don't show to anyone. Okay. What we're going to do now is, do we have someone with big headphones? I don't know, in bag maybe? Usually people bring with them those big headphones. Anyone? No? Okay, then we will need to do that without sound. Okay, can't show it for now. What I guess need you to do, so that's camera, you're there, great. Can you please take the opposite side? And how you heard about, I don't know who hasn't heard about it, wall of confusion? Yeah, kinda, yeah. But everyone is talking about it. Let's try it out. Stop talking about it. So please turn around, kinda don't look at us. Okay, what we have there is, we can show it to others. This is something what you expect. Are you a developer? Oh, now you're operations. Sorry, now you're developer. It happens all the time. This is your toolset. Right? Now you're a developer. Let's give you a pen. Where is it? I believe it doesn't change much. Don't show it to me. No. Don't show it. You're still around. Okay, this is your tool. Okay, since we don't have those huge headphones, what we will try just with few iterations. Don't look at me. Don't stop cheating. Try with few iterations how that developer can make a shippable product that operations would accept it. That's more about packaging, about shipping. That's what we DevOps usually are kind of responsible of. Okay, the easiest would be I need a third person as messenger. Kind of being an email, please. Anyone? Yes, please. No t-shirt for you. Okay, that's a gift for Accenture. Great. Okay, now you need to quickly describe what you want to get in result to the messenger quietly. So, oops, doesn't hear it. You're kind of, I will just speak on it So you don't hear anything. I can sing, I can dance, I don't know what you want me to do. But you don't have much time, right? You know that. So yeah. Kind of first iteration, done, deadline, go. And explain to developer how looks shippable product. It doesn't matter at this point what's in it, but that's a package, right? You can kind of do it on the ground, I guess. Okay, it's good. The issue there is that you're a very good email. You kind of made a screenshot, right? And now you're trying to repeat it. Okay. That's not an issue, I hope. But that is about this wall of confusion. Okay, I was trying to avoid talking about it, but I was somehow, So the usual issue. Have you seen it in your life? Getting an email with some information. Let's say it has a configuration value, and you need to set it true or false. And it says iv.dependency.management. What now? Right? And you need to ship your package with that configuration, right? Okay, great. We have first, let's look at it. That's kind of first results, right? Good. Do you accept it? Kind of the size, it doesn't matter, right? Since when? It doesn't matter where how big is hole, yeah, really? Kind of, let's say that's and then comes developer and says that it's kind of a feature, of course. Let's try to do second iteration, kind of bring some quality to it, please. But this one is deleted. Please, one more round. Now you're starting to get on manager's nerves. And okay, go on. Second iteration, you have a chance to do a better screenshot. Yeah. Let's say that we're now using kind of video conference, so you can turn around. And this is no good. No, we're not doing that. You can turn around and you're using video conference. That should be better than an email, right? At least you see the person's face. And you communicate. They kind of wave hands, right? Okay, start drawing.
Top of the box, in the left corner, I need a hole, square hole, on the top left behind corner.
Okay. So video conference failed. Think about it. Third round. No, first one. Now he's not even listening. He's just making a product. That's kind of another example of what we're doing on our daily life. Okay.
So what's more, big box
on the full size of the paper.
Yes. Okay.
Landscape it. What's landscape it?
Landscape.
Okay. And I guess, and this is basically a deadline. This is our salary. Yeah, it went harder than I expected, yeah, but environment, that's environment, right? Environment matters. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, you can keep it.
Okay.
Yeah. You can work on kind of trying to explain it for developers as yourself. Okay, that was kind of example how important is communication, and I'll get there in a second, but even people speaking to each other about a picture, they can't agree on simple things. So what you expect in IT, right? Okay. One kind of, everyone's asking, what is DevOps? What is DevOps? What is DevOps? What is DevOps? And at one point, when you try to answer all that questions, you kind of start thinking what isn't. I'm not getting into detail of that, but it is so broad nowadays. It's moving, it's transforming, and it's all around you. I mean, you want to start IT project, even during some designs, you should have DevOps. What that guy would do, I can, it's wrong to say a guy, and that's another kind of issue of DevOps, that if you want to start doing a new project, and you're saying, let's do DevOps, someone will come to you and say, I'm DevOps engineer. If you look at what is a DevOps, it will talk about taking development and operations, bringing them together and working together. So what the hell is DevOps engineer? How that guy come up? But that's how it is. You can't know everything. So you have that one kind of more specialized in this, in tools, in theory. Kind of, he can be also as a coach, just to keep these DevOps principles. But yeah, so even during analysis, you need someone who will say how it will work, how we will automate things. Can we do full automation from the very beginning and just do development? Is that possible? And actually it is. There are different kind of commercial off-the-shelf ways of doing that, but that all costs money. We to spend money, there are a lot of open source tools, but to implement them, that takes some effort. So now you have that kind of DevOps expert, or let's call it DevOps nowadays. So all the through the software development lifecycle, you will get to maintenance. And even there you will see DevOps, because someone will automate, let's say, automate monitoring of systems, just that you can get self-healing systems. It's not a black magic, it's all doable. You just need someone to do that. But the issue is that business kind of they doesn't understand it, because there's no real business value in putting kind of money in uptime. They need this business functionality, new features. Well, that's why DevOps is emerging. Business finally starts thinking about it. We don't need to go projects and fight for it. The world is changing, and that's the most important thing. If you are left behind, sorry, that's your issue. We just saw what happened, right? With that salary. So yeah, usual stuff. What we need, DevOps, and when always. That's how it is lately. Now everyone wants to do DevOps. they even don't care. The same thing happened with Agile a few years ago. Now it's happening with DevOps. Finally, we have at least real business cases to show how DevOps fail. That's also a good thing, just to show that you can't just start doing it. You need some knowledge before that. Okay, so we just talked about that, but that vision around the world, if you start reading different blogs, oh my God, you will dig up a lot of information, what is DevOps, what isn't DevOps, and the best answer at a job interview, so DevOps is, it's new and it's changing. And I can't say that that's the incorrect answer. It is kind of true, but yeah, job interviews, people make up different things. And yeah, so where to get it? From internet you will find so many services nowadays, a lot of them. Do that, do this, use Azure, do cloud, start all your stuff on CloudFormation, use Chef. They will come in up guy and say, wait, I do everything on Maven, and then those two guys are looking at each other and understanding that they are talking about totally different things. But as DevOps, we need to bind all that and make one unique working system from all these tools, basically. So it's hard, definitely hard. And still, on the internet you will find so many explanations. What is DevOps? And everyone has its own opinion, really. And they are quite sure that they are doing DevOps. I'm one of those guys also saying that I know DevOps. Yeah, and that's how it is for now. There are no kind of recognized books all around the world what exactly is DevOps. Everyone still is making up their own blogs on that, their own definitions. We'll get there. Okay. Now, not going deeper in all that stuff, but just if you dig up what is DevOps? This is first stuff what you get. Try to get out from this something. If you write in Agile, nowadays you will get usually the same kind of diagram, and you will have a kind of feeling that everyone's talking about the same thing. About DevOps, no, it's not going to happen. You'll get a lot of explanations of it. And then when you kind of have read it all and you have your feeling that you know what is DevOps or not ready to try it, okay, let's try some tools. And then it's wow. In Accenture, we tried to just put together tools what we use in kind of in relation with DevOps, just in Riga, and we ended up with 3 slides on different areas with tools on many lines. It was more than this. This is just 2 examples, 2 quick pictures from it all. But a lot of tools, a lot of open source, everything for free. Just come and get it. Not easy. But as DevOps, yeah, that's something what we do, what we learn, we implement. It always depends on a project. It always depends on a case, what you need, when you need it, and so on. And even to go further, even more ways of explaining DevOps. You can sit for days and read about DevOps, and every topic will be kind of a little bit different. What you will notice maybe that people are trying to make DevOps kind of fun. And that's a good thing. And that's about culture. That's about those DevOps people that let's stop being those kind of IT stereotypes, those geeks. Nowadays, it's changing. Okay. So, definitely, I said that there are no kind of one official book for DevOps, but this is definitely stuff you should read. Even if you're not doing DevOps, a lot of good stuff in these two books. Definitely, everyone is talking about them. But if you have no time, and that's what usually happens in real life, I guess I don't recommend it. I haven't read it, but. As usual, you always get this book for anything. I hope that people are not kind of actually using them as only material. Okay, 32. So my way of explaining DevOps, kind of. Yeah, DevOps. Just how to get there, how to get it in, how to make ourselves to do DevOps. And actually, yeah, the answer is very, very simple. Just if something hurts, do it more often. The first step, definitely, for some old, I don't know, mainframe project, whatever, just start automating things. You will get issues, definitely. Then, of course, that's about, I would say, continuous integration, about continuous delivery. If those are new words for you, definitely there is a lot of stuff to read. Step three, can't do often by yourself, get everyone doing it. And this is where DevOps actually comes in, the DevOps culture. Stop having one person doing those specific tasks. Have a team being responsible for full delivery. And that DevOps engineer, okay, he can kind of help others with that, just his practices and so on and so on. But just do it as a team. And that's about DevOps. Development and operations working together. Step four. So, and now we're getting basically to continuous deployment, I would say, at some point. It's just so automated that you can't do it more often. It's kind of we just built it, we deployed it, there's a new build, we deploy it, and that's it, and there's no way to stretch. So you need to start splitting things. And this will help a lot in development, in ways how later on you organize your releases in continuous deployment. Okay, you will not have kind of big releases, but it helps a lot to start doing things faster. Not just automate. Not just deployments. When you start splitting things up, it means that you start updating and changing small parts instead of big pieces. Finally, the fifth, again, basically about DevOps. You can't just take those tools and say that we're doing DevOps. You need to start changing your process, your business, to do it even more often. And then when you can say check, most probably you're doing DevOps, finally. I'll skip this one, unfortunately. Yeah, or we'll get there at end. Quickly, about evolution and generations. DevOps isn't a new thing. What basically happened, how I see it, we as a man, as a human, were evolving just fine until IT. And then we got these new IT systems, everything happening too fast, and for some reason we started to kind of limit ourselves of going further, and let's say that's a Michelangelo, who knew that this will happen. And many years ago, he was trying to remind everyone that don't limit yourself, do the best thing, push yourself, and so on. Yeah, of course. What happened in the result is in IT a lot of communications. And do you know a story about puppets and kettles? That's about servers, basically. Another thing that we started to do in IT is to care about our servers as a puppets, as a pets, really. And now this is my server, this is your server, this is your responsibility, this is mine, and let's take it to the doctor, something happened with it, and so on. That's how it is. And a lot does communicate. And finally, yeah, we got solution for that. Let's do waterfall. Let's make different teams responsible for everything. Let's do ITIL. And as for pets, yeah, let's control everything with configuration management database. And now we're just wasting money. Depends on the size of company, but millions. Just organizing our work. And that's, again, totally against DevOps. But that's how it happened. The world has changed now. I'll skip it or not. That's the question. No, I want to show it. Do you know the monkey beast illusion? How many know it? Okay, great. So please don't speak up, right? I will not stop it. The sound is not kind of... I will stop it at one point. But I'll continue later about it. But it's just watch it, think about it. Since we have no sound, so... Yeah. Just count what you need to count. I shouldn't be clicking that. Okay, now it's showing two different videos on each. That's interesting. Okay, so how many balls? You saw just answer, right? Nice. And it's starting from the beginning. It's not working as it... okay, let's skip it. But honestly, how much did you get? 17, okay. 14. Mm-hmm. Okay, good. So you know it was 16, right? And let's go ahead. Mm-hmm. So, did you? How many of you spot the gorilla? Usually it's a half. Okay. And where is it? Yeah. Whoa. Okay. So I'll just stop playing with video. Did you notice cartons changing color? How many of you noticed that? 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, not that many. And that's just a great example how working in such environment, you can just miss a lot of stuff, which is kind of not important. You need to count balls, and but there is colors changing, and who cares about that, right? We have more important stuff to do. So just something to think about. As Martin Croker says that's one of first DevOps practitioners. Again, just push yourself. Push yourself. It doesn't mean that you need to get there. It doesn't mean that you need continuous deployment. But you will closer. You will be closer somewhere around this point. Instead of just aiming for stable releases, then you will get stable releases someday, and the world ends there. Not going into detail, of course, but definitely, if you're interested, read about continuous deployment. If you can implement that, then most probably you're doing DevOps. Because you can't just take business and implement continuous deployment. It's impossible. So to get there, you will not have any other choice, basically. And then you get a lot of good stuff off it. I was talking about pets. So finally, you stop caring about servers as pets. Now those are cows or cattle. So if it gets ill, if something happens, just shoot it, and make a new one. That's how it's done nowadays. Of course, and that's without cloud. No, you can't do that. One important thing definitely about and talks about dog food. Years ago, that was very, very popular topic. Now we have kind of forgot about it, that if we make something, try it out by yourself. And that's again about DevOps. We make product for ourselves, basically. Think about communication. We just saw what happened there, right? Did this stuff some made you think a little bit about stuff what we're doing? I hope so. At least if a little bit, that's already a good thing. I guess I have something like 1 minute.
Plenty of time for questions.
Please,
Emily.
What is the easiest and quickest way to sell DevOps to clients?
Oh, yeah. Quickest and easiest. Quit your job. If you have a lot of kind of responsibilities back there, go to client, work for free, let's say, I don't know, for 3 months, something like that, and implement DevOps for them. And then you will be able to show difference. We actually have credentials in Accenture, kind of real numbers. That's, of course, that's Accenture stuff, right? I can't disclose that. But we have kind of these measurements, so how much saved from implementing DevOps or something like that. How those numbers are made, who knows? Because anything what you measure a year ago, it's a useless number if you measure it now. World is changing, everything is changing. The million, I don't know, a year ago, it could be just thousands today of doing the same thing, of the same waste. So it's hard to measure. But another way what you can say to the client, you will have something like cross-functional teams if you do it in right way. So everyone will know everything, and you will not need to care about backups, let's say, because everyone is kind of replacing themselves. You will have organized, kind of self-organized teams. It's all about Scrum. It's all about Agile. Of course, DevOps is not possible without Scrum or Agile, without Agile, let's say. But at the same time, we have done something like DevOps for Waterfall project. That's also doable. When you can improve or automate something, go for it, definitely. But definitely, it's hard. And previously, I was selling that as configuration management when there was no DevOps. And then what it was even harder, because explain configuration management to client and actually prove that this is what you need, well, hard, very, very hard.